So let's begin with our today's topic, link-shared routing protocols, that is your OSPF. So first we'll see the working of link-shared routing protocols, how they work. So these are the topics that we are going to cover in the first session of OSPF. So let's see how actually the link-shared protocol works, how the routing algorithm of the SPF algorithm of link-shared routing protocols, how it behaves, how it does the working. So now we know OSPF is a classes routing protocol, okay? And the version of OSPF that we use is OSPF version 2, and the algorithm used by OSPF is SPF. Like RIP version 2 uses your Bellman Ford algorithm, EIRP works with dual algorithm, and this guy OSPF works with SPF algorithm, which was actually invented by the person called Edgar Dijkstra's, okay? So Edgar Dijkstra was the one scientist who invented this algorithm SPF. So, repetitions of being much more complex than the distance we are routing counterparts. Now, you know, like OSPF has a way of saying, like OSPF is a little bit different from your distance vector routing protocols. Yeah, that's true. It's not very complex as they are saying, like, it's not complex. It's just, you have to understand how it works. It works very differently from compared to your distance vector and EIGR. So, functionality and configuration is not complex, but the algorithm is also easy to understand. Okay, I will first understand how the algorithm works. Okay, now distance vector, they have a road signs, correct? Like distance vector is like this way to go, that's it. But link state, they have an entire road map. That's the major difference in distance vector and link state routing protocol. RIP just has the road signs, correct? Link state will have an entire topology of a map. So distance and vector, what they talk about always, like which direction and we how long, correct? How much distance. And in link state, we have a topological map, that is a database table. Each router determines the shortest path after looking after topology table. So for example, they will see the first entire topology table and then they decide which is the best path. Now see this is over here. Can you see it? Now for example, the introduction of this SPF algorithm. SPF algorithm, Dijkstra's algorithm is known as what? SPF algorithm. That stands for shortest path first algorithm. So the shortest path first is really the objective of every routing algorithm, correct? Even RIP also has the shortest hop count. It says the best path. So now how it does decides which is the best path, correct? So let's go with the base of this first. Now see, R2 is going by this route, correct? So each router calculates the SPF algorithm and determines the cost from its own perspective. Now what is cost? We'll talk on this later. Now we know the every routing protocol has got some metric, that is RIP has a metric of hop counts, 15 hops is the max. EIGRP is a little bit different, which works with bandwidth and delay, so it has got a composite metric. Same way in OSPF, the metric is known by cost. Now what is the cost? It's very simple actually, it's just 10^8 divided by the bandwidth. So we'll see the concept, how the value we get. So if you see this cost, the cost of this thing is 20 plus 5 plus 2, that comes to 27. This destination I can reach by this route also, correct? But see the cost, 10, 20, 30, 32. So among these two, which is the lower cost? This guy, this route. So I'll prefer this route to reach this network of R3. Okay, so the cost of the shortest path first from here is what we saw now. So cost of 27 to R3 is LAN network, correct? So if you see like this, you know, like every router will have his own information, like from R1. Now let's see the SPF for R1. From R1 to reach the LAN of this guy, 20 plus 2, 22, see the cost. From R1 to R3, this is the best one, 5 plus 2, 7. If I want to reach this guy, it's 20 plus 2, 22. But if you see, if I go by this route, 5, 10, 15 plus 2, 17. So compared to this route, which is directly connected, I think this is the best part, lowest cost. And same way to reach here, if I go by this route, it's 20 plus 10, 30, 32. If I go by this route, also 20 plus 10, 30, 32. But wait, see this route, 5, 10, 15, 10, 25, 2, 27. So getting like how it goes actually. This is the way it finds the best part. Now let's see how these things happen in real life actually, in real world, how it happens actually. Now see, the shortest path is not necessarily the path which has the least number of hops. So in this case, or link state routing protocol, then you will not see the hops. They will see the cost. Understanding? So see, this is what I am using to reach here. Yeah? Now, shortest path for each router, let's see. Now see, these are the networks. So from R1 to reach anywhere, this LAN network of these guys, he has got his table. Same way we have a SPF for R2 again. R2 to reach here, 20 plus 2, 22. To reach here, 25, 5, 27. and to reach R4's RAM 20, 20, 42, 20, 25, 35, 37, again much more. But if I go at this route, 10, 10, 20, 22, so this is the best one. And say we to reach here 10 plus 2, 12. Okay, so like this, each shadow will have SPF 3. Okay, this is called as SPF 3 actually, correct?
Yes.
So now links to routing protocols. Each router learns about its own links when the interface is up and is directly connected. When you give the command no shutdown, correct? And it should be up on both the sides. And each router is responsible for meeting its neighbor on directly connected networks. Why? So that you can discover the OSPF neighbors, and after that you can send the hello packets to the neighbors. Each router builds its own link state packet, LSP, containing the state of each directly connected link. What is in that actually? It have a link type, like whatever link it is, serial link, Ethernet, the bandwidth, and the neighbor ID. So this way each router makes a link state packet. We'll see this, how it goes. Okay, link state packet is what? Information of that link. Now see in this topology, R1, he will have information of this link, as well as this link. Understand? So this is what is known as LSP, link state packet. Now each router floods the LSP to all neighbors, who then store all LSPs received in the database. Now what do we know? In this scenario, everyone starts flooding his LSA. Not LSA, the link state packet. He will give his link state packet to this guy. He will give his R3 will give his own to all these guys. There is a flooding of LSP happening, correct? And everyone will store all the entire information. So it is a collection of entire database. From that they will make a topology table. So I think that is the database table is called your topology table. So neighbors then flood the LSPs to the neighbors, and then all routers in the area have received the LSPs. So now each router uses the database to construct the complete map of the topology and computes the best path to each destination network. The SPF algorithm is used to construct the map of the topology and determine the best path to each network roadmap. This is what we saw before. So all routers will have a common map or tree, but each router will have independent determine the best path to each network, correct? So let's see this how it happens. See this R1 link 10.1 network 2, 3, 4. So he has got these 4 links over here. Each router learn about his own links which are directly connected. So interface configured with an IP address and subnet mask, of course, that I will address to my neighbors. And those who are directly connected and are not part of the routing table currently. Okay? Regardless of the routing protocols used. So they learn of all these links. Okay. Now R1 link is an interface on a router. What is the link? Link is an interface on a router. So these are all the 4 links, correct? Then for the link participating in the link state routing process, it must be the up state. So first of all, this should not be down. The interface should be up and included in the one of the network statements. So when OSPF is going to run that network, you have to add it under with the network command under the routing process of OSPF. Like network 10.1.0.0. We'll see the commands. So now link 1, what is the information? See the network IP address, type of network, I mean the type of link is Ethernet, the cost of this link, and neighbors. Currently on this, I have no neighbors, correct? There is no neighbors because there is a switch which goes to PCs, and PCs doesn't understand OSPF. Now for this guy, yes, I have a neighbor called R2. Can you see? Cost of the link, the type of network, serial link, IP address, and network. So this is there for everyone. So R1 will send this all information to his neighbors. Flood it. So link states like information about states of router link. What is the link state? Information about the state of router's link. So R1 will now start flooding this information to his neighbors. And type of network, we now saw everything, cost, and the neighbor if there are, correct? So initially, router is unaware of any neighbor routers on the link. First of all, they see he is unaware of the neighbor, correct? Then it learns of neighbor when it receives a hello packet from the adjacent neighbor. See, when I receive a hello, that time, okay, I come over. That is my neighbor over here. Okay. So now, sending hello packets to neighbors. So each router is responsible for meeting its neighbors on directly connected network. See, I have a neighbor over here, he should be directly connected. So that he is my neighbor, correct? Using a hello protocol to discover any neighbors on their links. Use a hello protocol. Okay, now you know, we saw yesterday EIGRP, we changed the hello protocol parameters. We changed the hello timers and whole time. Was my agency gone down? No. Because two neighbors, a different hello times, they are not an issue. But in OSPF, there's an issue. OSPF, both neighbors should have the same hello packet and the hold down timer. In OSPF, we call it a dead timer. In OSPF, hold down is called as dead timer. So they both should be same on both the routers. If one of the timer is changed, then the neighborship goes down.
Dead interval.
Like hold time and the hold time in EIGRP is called as dead time in OSPF. Okay? So a neighbor is any other router that is enabled with the same link state routing protocol, correct? OSPF on R1, OSPF on R2. If it's RIP, then we can't become neighbors. Two different routing protocols. So see, hello, I am R1, packet goes to all the neighbors. They reply, hello, I am R2, this guy say I am R3, he says I am R4. So these are my neighbors, I come to know, correct? So now, hello is what like just a keep alive function, correct? Which is sent after every 10 seconds on your serial link. Encapsulation HDLC protocol which it uses keeps on sending keep alive access. So hello, I am R1 and still here. It sends after every 10 seconds. Hello, I am R2, I am also still here. It's like a keep alive. Okay. So it's quite simple now. When it stops receiving hello packets from a neighbor, the neighbor is considered unreachable and the address is broken. But what after some duration? That's called dead times. Now in OSPF, the hello timer is of 10 seconds on fast Ethernet and point to point links broadcast. And 40 seconds of dead timer. Okay? But on NBMA, you can say frame relay, the hello is of 30 seconds and hold dead time is of 120 seconds. It's 4 times actually. So each router builds a link state packet containing the state of each directly connected link. So see here. This is for R1, the link state packet. Can you see like point link, network and cost, everything? Like this is going to be for everyone. It builds its own link state packet and the link state information about its links. And after establishes its agency, see. Each router builds a link state packet containing the state of each directly connected link. It sends to its neighbors. One sec. Sorry. So after establishes its agencies. Agency means your neighborship, correct? So once hello is done, then I exchange my information, correct? This is my information. These all these informations which are over here, I will send it to all my neighbors. It sends LSP our interfaces where it has established agency. Agency means the neighborship. Hello packets received, send and received. Okay, so to become neighbors. Now R1 has not sent LSP or Ethernet interface. Why? Because there is no one guy who is replying with the hello packet of OSPF, correct? Going ahead, see now. Each router floods the LSP to all neighbors who then store all the LSP received in the database. So now there will be flooding of link state packets. So each router floods its link state information, its link state information to all other link state routers. So there's a flooding of this guy. Then when a router receives an LSP from a neighboring router, it sends that LSP out all other interfaces. Now see, R4 has received this information, it send it to R3, send it to R5. Same way R3 will send information to R4. So see, this is what happened. It's called flooding effect. So link state routing protocols calculate the SPI algorithm after the flooding is complete. So first there is a flooding storm happening, see, like this. And then they will calculate the SPI algorithm on the basis of the entire map. So all LSP needs to be sent only during initial startup of the router or the routing protocol process. Now flooding has happened only in the initial startup. After that they keep in touch with their POP, keep alive, there's the hello packets. But after every 30 seconds they refresh the database tables, they refresh it. After 30 minutes, yeah, they refresh it. So see, now whenever there is a change in the topology, the link going up and down, neighbor has been come up, new agencies come up or broken, that time they will only send a triggered updates. Okay, they will send a triggered updates. Okay, now see, step 5, constructing a link state database. So see, these are database of R2, R3, R4, R5 and R1. Entire database is there. So step 5, the final step. Each router uses the database to construct a complete map of the topology and compute the best part of each destination network. So now each router will then have an LSP from every linkshare router and it's been stored in your linkshare database. So this is my entire database table. In EIGRP we call it topology table. But EIGRP, it receives the information only what the neighbor router tells it, correct? Over here it is flooded throughout the entire network. That's the difference in OSPF. So see, these are where it is flooded. So each router in the routing table area now can use the SPF algorithm to find the best path to reach the final destination. Okay? So now we saw this constructing a link state database. We saw this very well how these things are happening, correct? So SPF algorithm results in a SPF tree. So this is a tree, correct?
Yes, sir.
So now see, at first the tree only includes directly connected networks, neighbors. First neighbors, directly connected. Yeah. Then under the link state information from all other routers, R1 now can begin to construct an SPF tree of the network with itself as a root of the tree. Now R1 will add a root, and these are my tree. Okay. So R1 processes the LSP from R2, it receives from R2. Now see the entire way how it works. The SPF algorithm begins by processing the following LSP information from R2. R2 has sent its LSP information to me. From R1's perspective, if I need to reach the R2's LAN network, see. connected to neighbor R1 on network, this one with a cost of 20. It's connected to neighbor R5, so I came to know, okay, he's connected to R5. So I can reach R5 by this guy. Yeah, its cost is 10. So for me, the cost should be 10 plus 20. That would be 30. And it has a network of 10.5 with cost of 2. So from this, I can make out the entire process. Same way with R3. So see, red is what? A new information for R1. R1 knows about this link, but he got new information from R2 about this link, correct? Same way, now we are looking for R1's perspective. Now R3 has given the information. R3 gives me about this information. These are same, common network. But I come to know about this new network from R3 with that cost. So I could make up one more new information. I got it. Now from R4's perspective, this link is common, but it will give me the information of this and this link. Correct?
Yes.
Now this link has information given to me by R3. It gives me this link information with the cost. Correct? Like this, an entire database table has been made up. The SQL algorithm is calculated. So, and this is the new information. We are now aware of this link because R2 told me about this link and R4 told me about this link, correct?
Yes.
So, at the end, the entire table is done and now R1 has reconstructed the complete SPF tree, correct? So, when that tree is built, so under the SPF tree, now SPF algorithm results in the shortest path. Now, let's see the shortest path to reach each of these destinations. Note, only the LANs are shown in the table, but SPF can also be used to determine the shortest path across each WAN link also. Now, this is a common, simple, and small topology. But when you go beyond that time also here, this will be used. Now, to reach this network, from here, this is the best path. To reach this network, this is the best path. Correct? To reach this network over here, again, this is the best path. So if you see now, everything is calculated like this. Understanding how SPF works? Very interesting, the base power actually concept of your SPF algorithm, how it goes. See again, this is the link, correct? So after this, the entire SPF tree has been done and SPF path has been defined. Each router constructs its own SPF tree independently from all other routers. Now see, R1 has got own independent SPF tree. R4 will have its own independent SPF tree. The link state databases must be identical on all routers. See, database tables will be same, but the best path will be different, correct? So generating a routing table from the SPF tree. So then after that, the routing table. The best information comes into your routing table from the database table. It comes to your routing table. Traffic and networks will be shown as C, and which are run via OSP is shown as O in intra area shown as O. Okay, so routes from any other sources such as static routes also can be shown over here. Traffic and networks can also be shown, and packets now will be forwarded according to these entries in the routing table. So this is how your link state protocol works. Okay, so now moving ahead, implementing link state routing protocol, what are the advantages and all this stuff, let's see. Now, builds a topology table. Now, you got to know that it has a topology table. Distributed gateway protocols do not have the full topology map, correct? They only have the next hop information. And that's which the neighbor tells you. So, using SPF tree, each router can independently determine the best part of the network, the shortest part in actual. So, fast convergence, like for example, it immediately floods the LSP out of all interfaces except for the interface from which it was received. And if this goes down. This guy goes down. So, it will send it to everyone, correct? So the lack of hold down timer, which is a distance gateway routing protocol feature designed to give the network time to converge, correct? Hold down timer, you know, like it waits for the hold down timer to expire, then it sends a, then it says okay, the network has gone down, hold down timer expired, then the network gets to converge, okay? But it, as in the changes in the topology are happening, it's a flooded immediately between the LSPs. Distance gateway is how it is, like hold down timer expires, then we send the updates, correct? Over here it's not like that. RIP. You know, invalid timer, first timer, and hold down timer. So that's the concept. So it sends immediately, it starts immediately to my neighbors. So only send out to LSP when there is a change in topology. So again, when sent, they send all event driven updates. When there is an event happening, that time the updates are sent. Okay. So only the information, again, only I'm sending information only of the affected link, not about all my links. I'm not sending my entire routing table, only the link which is affected. Okay. Unlike some distributed routing protocols like RIP, link state routing protocols do not send periodic updates. RIP sends periodic updates, this guy never sends periodic updates. So OSPF routers do flood only old link states up every 30 minutes. Just like just refresh it, and they are called paranoid updates. Okay? Like just to refresh your entire database. So link state via OSPF and ISIS. ISIS is now out of your routing topic. CCNP and even I level. We can do some summarization. So this is all you see practically how to do summarization. As I said, you got hierarchical design. So now let's talk on this. You know this area 0, area 1, area 51. Now what's the concept of area? If there are no areas, this all will be one OSPF domain. So which should be not very tough to handle, but it's very cumbersome to handle up such a big network, correct? And if one link going down over here, it will be front door all the routers over here. So over here, OSPF came up with a better idea of having a concept of areas and then connecting to different areas. Now, you know what it says? It's OSPF says, I require hierarchical design, where area 0 should be the main point, focus point, and all other areas should connect to area 0. But again, sometimes we might find a topology where area 51 is over here, and I got one more area over here. But that thing is, you know, is known as a bad design of a network. Again, say bad design of your OSPF protocol. So always see that every area is going to backbone area. Okay, but if I have only one area, it doesn't mean it should be only area 0. If I have only one single area, it can be area 1 also, it can be area 2 also, only single area. But when you are going to have two areas, one has to be area 0, the backbone. Okay, and now I will just talk on this later after some time. More on this, we go to the next topic. Okay, so now let's go ahead with the topic of OSPF. We just saw now how the link set protocol works, how the SPF is being generated, how the SPF path is calculated, and how the SPF, after running the SPF algorithm, how is the best path information is kept in the routing table. So we just saw this before. Just a small review of OSPF. We know very well now OSPF is a classless routing protocol. It's a link, it comes under the category of link state, and it has a concept of scalability of areas. It has areas for scalability. Now we'll talk on this more when we talk about multi areas. Then the metric of OSPF is called as cost. Then it uses the bandwidth to calculate the OSPF metric cost. The formula is very simple, 10 is straight upon the bandwidth, then you get a cost. Then okay, commands we'll talk later. Now a group of OSPF routers that share link state information. Now see, network wildcard marks, that's okay. Area ID we'll see. Now we just saw one brief idea of area. Now OSPF deals with the concept of areas. So the syntax of router OSPF, under router OSPF defining network is what? Network, the network address, wildcard mask, the inverse mask, and you have to define the area ID, like which area does this interface belongs to. Okay, so all our routers in the same area must have same link state information and the same link state database. Of course, in one area, all routers will have the same link state database, the topology map. Okay, and this is accomplished by routers spreading the link state individual information, that is called LSPs, which we saw now. So how do you go? See, first, running of link state information everywhere. Step 2, build the entire database table. Then run the SPF algorithm. Have the SPF tree. And from tree, find the best path and keep it in the routing table. This is the first step process of your link state protocol. Correct? Now, let's see how they form neighbors. Neighbors and adjacencies. So, before two routers can form an OSPF neighbors, they must agree on three values, some values. Like as I told you before, that hello packet has to be same. So, hello interval, dead interval has to be same, and network type. See, of course, if they are point-to-point link or even broadcast link, the network type has to be same, correct? So, hello interval, date interval has to be same, okay? Which is not a case in EIGR. In OSPF, it has to be same. And the last one, your network and network marks also has to be same for two routers to become neighbors. Net marks also has to be perfect, okay? And IPU, MTU must match. Now, this is not a very big topic, actually. It's not a very big issue over here, IPU, MTU. Now, as I told you, 10 seconds of hello for multi-access, that is broadcast and point-to-point segments, point-to-point and multi-access, that is your Ethernet. 30 seconds for your NVMe links, that is your frame relay. So again, now OSPF is a very vast topic. We are going to see a lot of things. We'll go one by one into this topic slowly, okay? So in most cases, use multicast address of, okay. Now we saw RIP version 1 sends updates as a broadcast, that is 255.255.255.255, correct? RIP version 2 sends the updates on 224.0.0.9 and EIGRP sends the updates on 224.0.0.10. What is the protocol number of RIP? It is 520. EIGRP uses the protocol number 89 and OSPF works with 88. Okay, I think 89 or 88. Again, this small one, you know, something you forgot.
OSPF 89.
So now going ahead, 40 seconds and 100 seconds for frame relay networks and NVMe. Okay. This is a dead timer, sorry. 10 seconds is the hello packet for multi-access, 30 seconds is the hello for NVMe, 40 for dead interval for multi-access, and 120 for NVMe. Dead interval expires, the neighborship goes down. That's what, removes the neighbor from the link state database. Again, removes all the information that is related to the neighbor. It floods the link state information about the down neighbor to out all other enabled interfaces. If this guy goes down, I'll enable to flush this information to all these guys. If this guy goes down, I'll inform to this guy over here, this guy over here. No, nobody's OSPF over here, but at least this guy over here. So, now we'll see all these things practically. Now see dead time. You know guys, even in SHU-RP ERP neighbor, it shows you the hold down time. 7 sure we also never shows the dead time. 40 seconds. So it refreshes every 10 seconds when it receives a hello from the neighbor. So these are commands to change the hello dead interval. Same like EIGRP. We had the IP hello interval or EIGRP 1 and the parameter. Then IP hold time. The whole time or something it was like that, I think. Whole time. Then EIGRP, AS number and the interval. Now there's a topology we have to configure, the basic topology of OSPF. Okay, now before I go in a practical way, let me show you some things. Also used in DRBA processors, okay, router ID. Now, in OSPF, every router has been identified by, one sec. Okay, now in OSPF, every router is identified by a router ID. Now, what is the router ID? Now, router ID, either you can give the command, like the command router ID under the OSPF process. Okay, any IP address you are typing. But see that IP address is not used on the network. If you are giving the command, router ID. If you don't specify this command, OSPF router will choose the... Now see, for example, these are the interfaces over here. OSPF router will choose the highest IP address of the loopback interface. If loopback is present. If there are 10 loopbacks, the one with the higher IP address, that will become my router ID. If there are no loopbacks, then OSPF fallbacks to physical interface. So any interface which has got a higher physical interface IP address, see here, now this is 172.192.192, this 10.5, this 10.1 is 172, of course this is lower one, so among these two, 10.5 is a bigger one, so this guy becomes the router ID. So when R1 forms the neighborship with R2, when I give the command on R2 show IP OSPF neighbor, it will show you this IP address as the router ID. So don't get confused, how it forms the neighborship with this interface. No, it is nothing but the neighborship with this guy only, but his router ID is of this interface. So it's better always, you know, to use loopback interface as a router ID. Why? Because if the router reboots, the physical interface doesn't come up automatically. You gotta give the command no shut. Whereas loopback interface comes up automatically. So it's always beneficial. Either you give hardcore router ID command or use loopbacks. Okay? See. Loopback IP address like router ID. So every router identified in OSPF by a router ID. Router ID can be configured by command of router ID and the OSPF process. Or it can be highest IP address of a loopback interface, or it can be highest active IP address of a physical interface. So we can give the command router ID, you can type it. Okay, we'll see this, how to do it practically, everything. Then, okay, now I think we'll just start with one small lab. Okay, so we are just configuring this lab in our GNSC. So, oh, one my thing, what your mistake? I didn't give my router ID. Now you know what to do. And we can't reboot this router, so that's the issue. Okay, no problem. Let me see. R1, the neighborship has come up with this. See, what the router ID can. They can the router ID of the physical interface. Can you see? Yeah. And you know, in GNSC, I can't reboot the routers. After rebooting, it goes to auxiliary port. So that's the issue. So, if I change the router ID, let me try on one router. Router ID 10.1.1.1. And there, you know, the option of clear IP OSPF process. Clear IP OSPF process. Where you start? Nothing. All the preset, yes. Let's see if it works fine by this. Now if you went down, come up. Okay. Now let's go and see on R2. Or R2. Yeah, it has taken a router ID. That's great. So let's do all the routers. So router ID 10.2.2.2. Because you know why? Router ID command, if we want to change something, like if they say you need to reset the OSPF process. Sometimes it works or sometimes you have to reboot a router to take the effect. Okay, so now we are saying clear IP OSPF process, enter. Oh, I said no, yes. Let's join R3, so that my entire series has become neighborship 10.1, that's good. So here also change it, router ID 10.3.3.3, clear IP OSPF process. Great. So now say it will show 10.2.1. That's great. That's awesome. So it worked fine over here. Now going ahead, if you see here, show IP OSPF process. Sorry, not process, neighbor. Can you see neighbor? There are two neighbors, 10.3.3. So I'm identified by neighbors with my router ID. Then the priority is 0. Now what is priority? We'll talk later. State is full, we'll see in some time. What is the state meaning? Dead time or yeah, the dead interval, like see if see the value 31, 30. 39. See ya? See ya. And this will also keep on rising. See, 35, 34. Both are just a second difference. Both will go back. See, earlier in 30 minutes. Now the address of my remote neighbor, 10.6, to which I am reaching this neighbor. Yeah? And this is the interface of mine through which I am going to this neighbor, 10.3. This interface S10 goes to my neighbor 10.2. Okay? Now let's go as per the side explanation. Swipe yourself neighbor, we just saw this. Neighbor ID, first is my neighbor ID. Priority is OSF priority of the interface. Now in our case it is 0 because it's a point to point link. Now what is priority is a very big role is going to play over here. We'll see within some time. State, OSF tail interface, the full state. The full exchange of database will happen and the state is full. Now there are 7 states. We'll see now, I think not 7. It's 7 states. Whatever the states very soon. The dead timer. The IP address of the neighbor interface. Now this is a neighbor interface IP address to which I am reaching that neighbor. So if I see R1. From R1, I am reaching my 10.2 to R2, that is my 10.2 router, and 10.6 to reach my R3 router, correct? So, and the interface, my local interface to which I am reaching my neighbors. This is the information of your SUIP OSPF neighbor, quite simple to understand. Now, let's give this command SUIP OSPF interface and the serial interface name. So, let me clear up this thing. SUIP OSPF interface serial 1/0. The interface is up, protocol means layer 1, layer 2 things are up. Layer 1 means no shut is done, layer 2 means the protocol is same. So no, and clock is also given. IP address of this interface is such and such and it belongs to area 0. Process ID 1, that is router OSP process ID 1 which are given, router OSP of 1, that is the process ID. In EIGRP it is the AS number, the difference. Actually it is also process ID but we call it as the AS number. We identify it as the AS number. Router ID, what is that defined? Network type is point to point. The cost of my link is 64. Now let me show you. Show interface serial 1/0 1544 kilobytes per second, correct? Yeah. Now let me show you one table. We will show you the cost of all different links. So give me one second. Okay. So, just see this table over here. If you see it's a 56 Gbps link divided by 10 straight divided by this, you get this value. So as the link is getting faster, the value is 1. Now for faster it is 1, but what about 1 gig? It has to be 1. What about 10 gigs? Again it has to be 1. But for that again we have something called as the reference bandwidth issue. The reference bandwidth answer, right? What is 10 to 8 actually? It's a reference bandwidth. So the interfaces with the higher bandwidth values will have a lower calculated cost, of course. We saw it's 1. So 1 gig will also be again 1. 10 gigs will also again 1. Okay? So 10 to 8 is again for your reference bandwidth. Okay? So this is what we saw, the cost it comes to 1. So you can also give the command auto cost reference bandwidth and then new command. So when necessary, use on all routers so the OSP routing metric remains consistent. So if you are going to use it, if I got a gigabit ports, so you can change it. For the command auto cost reference bandwidth, you can give the bandwidth what you already defined. But see that you give it on all the routers so that the metric is consistent throughout all the entire topology of the MAC. Okay, this you'll see later. I just showed you this part just to make you understand. Okay. So now let's come back over here. So we saw network type. Then we saw the hello timer, 10 seconds, dead timer 40 seconds, correct? Okay, now next hello is in my 9 seconds, is it showing me over there? Now, some more things like neighbor count, how many neighbors do I have? 1, adjacent neighbor is 1, adjacent with neighbor 10.222. Now see this interface is having only 1 neighbor, can you see? But if I talk about 1/1, now you see how, I am showing about interface, I am talking about interface, correct? Now again 1/1 also have only 1 neighbor. Adjacent count is 1. So adjacency only with neighbor is 1 at adjacency means I have one neighbor, I have full neighborship with that neighbor and full adjacency. Let's call friendship. Okay? Then some basic things I just talked on this. So we saw this. Now the command SUIP protocols. Let's try this command on our routers. SUIP protocols. Okay. If you just compare here, OSPF is a process ID. Router ID, yes, we can see this in our router also. You see router ID, yeah. Number of areas in this router is 1. We only belong to one single area. That is only that one is a normal area. Now what is stub? Yesterday we saw stub in EIGRP, but that in EIGRP we can make one router as a stub. But in OSPF I can make my entire area as a stub. So that we'll see later in next week. Then NSSA all for the advanced topics we'll see that next week. Maximum path load balancing, 4 equal cost load balancing, which is going to be same for all the different routing protocols, be it EIGRP or DIP. Version 1, version 2, all do equal cost balancing for 4 paths. Then routing for these networks, okay, I am routing for these networks. The reference bandwidth is such currently at Mbps. That's why the value is 1. And these are the gateways to which I am reaching my other neighbors. Can you see? See, these old neighbors, it's still showing me. You know, first I formed agency with the physical interface. Then I changed the router ID. So it's still showing me. See, 7 minutes before I had an episode with these two guys. So this will get put after 30 minutes. Correct? That time this information gets removed. Okay? Now, going ahead, the AD value of this guy is how much? 110. Correct? The AD value of OSPF. So these are my OSPF neighbors and my AD values. Now, show IP OSPF. Let me try this command. Show IP OSPF. Let me compare and let me show you over here. Again, process ID and your router ID. Then some key concepts over here. Initial SPF schedule delay 5 seconds. It's 500 milliseconds, that is actually 5 seconds, correct? Yeah? Is this correct? I am saying? It's 500 seconds. It's microseconds, so divide which comes to divide by 10, it's 500 seconds, sorry. My mistake is of every 500 seconds, correct? Am I wrong or am I correct? Yeah. Okay. So, what do these things mean actually? Then minimum hold time between two consecutive SPF algorithms. What is all saying actually? Then my area type is area is backbone 0, that's okay. Number of interfaces in this area is 3. No authentication and SPF algorithm last executed. Let me show you R1. See some basic things like. Okay, this is what you saw, router ID, that's okay. Then the minimum hold time and the router, sorry, initial and these two values, we have to talk about this more on this. Then minimum LSA interval is 5 seconds, that's okay. Then something more that we saw coming down. Area is backbone 0. Number of interfaces in this area is AR 3. Now see if you see here. This interface, all the routers belong to area 0, yeah? Yes. So this guy and the partial, they all belong to area 0, okay, that's okay. Then, what happened, yeah, it's okay. Then SPF algorithm last executed about 8 minutes before. Executed 3 times till now, executed this algorithm 3 times to find the best path. Area ranges are again, number of LSAs, 3, we have the, now all the LSA will talk in next week. What this mean, LSA, all this concept, okay? So now, going ahead. What is it mean? Initial SPF schedule delay of 500 milliseconds. Now see, for example, anytime router receives any information about topology, like addition, deletion, the router must run the SPF algorithm, correct? Must rerun the SPF algorithm. Now, if I get information, should I run the SPF algorithm immediately after getting the information or should I wait for some time? So this says initial SPF schedule delay. If I get any updates, I will wait for first 500 milliseconds, that is how much? 500 seconds before running the SPF algorithm. Then I will create, of course, when I run the SPF algorithm, I will create a new SPF tree and then update my routing table, correct? So now the SPF algorithm says, it's again, SPF algorithm is CPU intensive and the time it takes for the calculation, it depends on the size of the area. More bigger area, more bigger routes, it takes more time to calculate, correct? So here he says, for example, there might be a flapping link. See, a flapping link like link going up and down, okay, a link that we lose can cause OSPF routers in an area to constantly recalculate the SPF algorithm, preventing from proper convergence. So it will not be converged, it will get converged again, flapping, correct? So if there is a route in the routing table, the router will continue to forward the packet, correct? So, but what's the issue over here? SPF schedule delay, what it says? Sorry, it was 5 seconds, my mistake, it's not 500 seconds. That's what I was saying, it's 5 seconds actually, okay? It's 5000 milliseconds, so that is 5 seconds, okay? So, to minimize this problem, the router waits 5 seconds, that is 5000 milliseconds. After receiving an LSU update, before running the SPF algorithm. Now see, we have two routers, you have one of the link goes down, you send me the update. And I'll run the SPF algorithm, yeah, absolutely, but not immediately after receiving the update from you. I'll wait for first 5 seconds. Because I'm assuming that within that 5 seconds, you might send me one more update during that second. See, if your link went down, I start running the SPF algorithm. And within that some 2 seconds, you send me the update again, that link is up. So again, I have to rerun the SPF algorithm. So what I do, you send me update, okay, I say, okay, I will run the SPF, but let me wait for 5 seconds. After 5 seconds, I run the SPF. Once the SPF run is complete, and you send me update again, that link is up. Should I rerun the SPF, algorithm now? Yes, I rerun it, but again, the gap, you know, between them is almost 10 seconds. So these are two delay, or you can say the scheduled delay and the minimum hold time, two SPF algorithms to be run. So see, first, I will wait for 5 seconds, then run the algorithm. After that, you send me an update immediately that your link is up. So to prevent a router from constantly running the SPF algorithm, there is an additional hold time of 10 seconds. So Radha waits for 10 seconds after running the SVO algorithm before rerunning the algorithm. So you send me the update, I wait for 5 seconds, then I run my algorithm, algorithm running is complete, okay. You send me the update again, but again I'll wait for 10 seconds, the gap, wait to SVO algorithm, okay. Then I'll rerun the SVO algorithm. This is called the scheduled delay and the minimum hold time between two SVO algorithm. Got it? So this is what is shown over here. In this router, these two parameters we just showed you over here, these things. Okay. So going ahead. Then we saw the network type is point to point. Yeah. Now show IP route the table. The routing table. We saw the neighbor table. We saw topology table. No, we're not saying topology table yet. Show IP route. See, I'm showing O for OSPF. I said this guy is saying to this is network. I got two routes. Equal cost, see 120 and 120 here. Correct?
Yes.
See the cost, 65, 65, okay? So if you calculate the cost for each and every line from R1 to reach this network 10.0, what is the cost? 65. How it is, you know? See. Show IP OSPF interface S1/0, which is going to R2. Cost is 64. Now let me go on R2 and see the cost of the link towards 10.0 network, correct? Now show IP interface link. 10 is connected to which network? Pass Ethernet. Correct?
Yes.
So I give the command show IP OSPF interface FA0/0. See the cost is 1. So our R1 it shows me the entire cost is almost 65. How? So minus 64 plus 1 is 65. So same way if our EID is showing 128, how? 64 plus 64, that is 128. This is 10.8. Okay? So understood?
Yes.
So unlike leaf version of EIGRP, OSPF does not automatically summarize our major network boundaries. Interview question. Interview question. Remember OSPF and EIGRP and RIP. RIP and EIGRP, they always do summarization. But you call it the major network boundary. But OSPF doesn't does it. See the OSPF table. Oh. See it. Okay, it's showing like showing SAS-study summated again and 1/16 is variably summated. Can you see? Nothing is summarized. It's showing me all the updates, correct? It's showing me everything. What happened? Oh, my PC has gone slow. Don't know why. Come up, wake up. One sec. What happened to this guy? Got stuck. Okay, so now my system is okay. It's working fine. Let's go back. So we saw that OSPF never summarizes anywhere. Now, what we can do summarization OSPF on some of the routers. Again, new things, ABR, ASBR, next week. Currently, we are just using CCNA level OSPF we are just talking about. What happened again? Why is it getting stuck over here? Again, it's got stuck. Now, let's talk about the ERB OSPF metric. Now, OSPF metric, I just showed you the cost, the things. We just talked about the reference band is also. So you can see the technical definition given over here. The cost is configurable by the system administrator also. Yes, with the bandwidth command, we can change it. And the lower the cost, best is the metric that always follow actually. Most of the interface is to be used for forwarded data traffic. So let's go ahead. I think when I start my recording, it gets stuck. Did you see? So now going ahead. No, again I need to.